Hey guys, what's up? It's Charlie here, and today we're going to be looking at what would happen if all of mankind lived in one city. Right now, the population of the entire world is around 7.5 billion people. That's almost an impossible amount of people to imagine in one place at one time. After all, the world's largest gathering, which took place in India, was only 3 million people. But did you know that theoretically the entire world could actually fit into one city? Today we're going to look at the city's size, the languages, the intelligence, and the wealth of that one city. But first, why not subscribe and press the notification bell too? City size. So the first thing we need to look at in our city of 7 billion people is how big is it going to be? Despite everything you hear about overpopulation, humans actually only take up a tiny amount of space on Earth. Overpopulation relates to things like jobs and the economy, not space on Earth. So that means the size of our city containing everyone in the world would depend on population density. This is basically the measurement of how many people you have per square kilometer. So the question is, do you want our city to have a high population density or a low one? If your population density is a high one, this means we don't have much space and are very cramped. But if our city has a low population density, this means there's lots of space for everyone. For example, if we had the same population density as Reykjavik, Iceland, this would mean 430 people would be in each square kilometer. This would mean our city containing everyone in the world would be around the size of Russia. Everyone knows Russia is the world's largest country by far. But if we wanted everyone to have a lot of space, our city would need to be the size of Russia. But what about if we wanted the same population density as Quebec, Canada? Their population density is 1,041 people per square kilometer. This would mean our city would be much smaller than Russia. Instead, it would be the size of Australia. The population density of Chicago is 4,492 people per square kilometer. So if we wanted our city to have the same population density as Chicago, our city would need to be the size of Iran. Now, if we wanted quite a high population density where people in our city wouldn't have much space, we can use Singapore as an example. Singapore has one of the highest population densities out of any country on Earth. This is 7,473 persons per square kilometer. If we had this very cramped population density, our city would be the size of Egypt. Manhattan in New York City is also a very famous example of a densely populated area. Many people live in very high apartment blocks here, as there's not much space per person. The population density of Manhattan is 27,826 people per square kilometer. If our city containing all of mankind had this population density and we built very high, we could all fit into New Zealand. Another example of very high population density is Manila, Philippines. Here, the population density is 43,079 people per square kilometer. This would mean our city containing 7.5 billion people would need to be the same size as Uruguay. But what if our city was as cramped as the slums of Davarai, India? Davarai is located in Mumbai. And there, the population density is 277,150 people per square kilometer. This is because it's incredibly cramped and you often have many families living under the same roof. But if we didn't mind all living like this, then our city would fit into the size of Belgium. And now for the most extreme example. This is the place with the highest population density in the world. I'm talking about Kowloon, Hong Kong, which has the world's highest population density. This is around 1.4 million people per square kilometer. If our city also had this insanely cramped population density, it would fit into Palestine. So that's how big our city would have to be, depending on how much space we wanted everyone to have. If we wanted everyone to have a lot of space like they do in Reykjavik, Iceland, then our city would be the size of Russia. But if we didn't mind people being very cramped up, we could all fit into Palestine. So now we have the size of the city out of the way, let's look at what goes into the city. Languages. You may be wondering, if we all lived in one city, what language would we speak? The world is made up of around 6,500 languages. But around 2,000 of those languages have fewer than 1,000 speakers. The world's most popular language is Mandarin Chinese. There's around 1.2 billion people who speak that language in the world. This means the most common language in our city would be Chinese. 17% of people would speak that. Then 9% of people would speak English. 8% would speak Hindi. 6% would speak Russian and 6% would speak Spanish. 4% of people would speak Arabic in the city. and then 50% of the city would speak various different languages. So even if we all lived in the same city, it would likely be divided up into different languages. But if we lived in this city, it would be very strange crossing the street and then having to speak a totally different language. Diversity. Obviously, in a city containing 7.5 billion people, we'll have a very diverse area. In our city, 48% of people will be men, while 52% of people will be women. Also, 70% of people will be adults, while 30% of people will be children. 61% of people in our city would be Asian, as that's the largest continent. Then, 13% of people would be African, and 13% will be from the Americas. 12% of people will be from Europe, and 1% from Oceania. Also in our city, we'd need lots of different areas to pray in. 33% of our city would be made up of Christians. 19% would be made up of Muslims. 13% of people would be Hindu, and 6% would be Buddhist. And 29% would be other religions and those who have no religion. So that just goes to show, if all of mankind lived in one city, it would be crazy diverse. We'd literally have every culture in the same city. We'd literally have every single culture in the same city, and it would be really interesting. Chances are people would learn a lot from each other, and we would get along a lot better. Intelligence. So, how intelligent would our city of all of mankind actually be? Well, in our city, 86% of people would be able to read, while the remaining 14% would be unable to read. This is around the same as the literacy rate of Bahrain. Bahrain ranks 144 out of all of the countries when it comes to literacy, so we're not doing too great. The most literate countries in the world are Ukraine, North Korea, and Uzbekistan, which all have a rate of 100%, while the least literate countries are Afghanistan, South Sudan, and Chad. Also in our city, 1% of people would have a college education, while the remaining 99% of people in the city would not have a college education. This obviously reflects the world and how educated the world is. Due to poverty, many people do not have a college education in the world. So that would mean our massive city would only have a few colleges, as only 1% of people would go to them. Technology. If you live in the Western world, you may look around and assume everyone has a phone. But in the wider world, that's simply not the case. And because of this, only 7% of people in our city would have computers. This means the remaining 93% of people in our city wouldn't have a computer. Now, when it comes to electricity, a lot of people do have that. 76% of the city would have electricity, but 24% of our city would not have electricity. This reflects the world and the large areas which have no electricity whatsoever. Wealth. Now, let's look at money. If mankind was a city, it would be one of the most unequal cities in the world. 6% of people would own 59% of all of our wealth, and all of those people would be from the USA. 74% of people would own 39% of all of the wealth, and 20% of people would only have 2% of all of the world's wealth. This really just shows how unequal the world really is. And if all of mankind lived in one city, it would be the most unequal city compared to every other city we have right now. Safety and health. Finally, let's look at something very important. How healthy and safe is our city? Well, to be honest, our city would have a lot of pollution. 68% of people in our city would breathe clean air, but 32% would breathe polluted air. Also, not everyone in our city would have clean water. 83% of our city would have access to clean and safe water, but 17% of people in our city wouldn't. Also, our city is incredibly bad when it comes to food. 50% of people in our city would not have a reliable source of food. However, 30% of people would always have something to eat. 20% of people would be undernourished. 1% of people would actually be passing of starvation. And 15% of people in our city would be overweight. So if all of mankind lived in one city, that's how it would look. We've been able to see the size, languages, diversity, intelligence, technology, wealth, health, and safety. And of course, this is all a reflection of the wider world condensed into one city. It's very interesting and kind of sad to see how unequal the world is. But it sure is interesting to visualize all of mankind living in the same city. Check out the poll in the top right corner and vote for if you think all of mankind would work well living in one city. Also, if you want some more amazing videos, then check out my second channel. There'll be a link to that coming up on screen in a moment. But as always, thanks for watching. Check out some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.